So now, hope you can see. So, yes, guys. So, in order to start chapter number two, my dear friends, we have proceeded with a different approach, which we call it as four pillars of accounting. In four pillars of accounting, so we have pillar number one, assumptions. Pillar number two is concepts and conventions, and pillar number three is golden rules of accounting, and pillar number four is accounting standards. So yesterday, detailed introduction about this so has been given. Now, so today what we are going to discuss is pillar number one and two has been covered in chapter number two. Pillar number three will be completed, is nothing but journal, so which is chapter number five, and accounting standard, which is chapter number three, what we are going to cover with. So let's start today. So chapter number two. So first, what is principles and policies are there? So that name alone, what is principle, what is policy, that alone let us discuss first. Then principle means what, and policies how it will be, this and all. Let us start a discussion. Yeah, so let's start. Accounting principles and policies. Yes, to start with, my dear friends. So first let us discuss what is principle, policies and principles. So first definition is principle. Accounting principle. Accounting principles. Right on. Accounting principles are nothing but, my dear friends, they are concepts. Concepts. Concepts and conventions. Accounting principles are nothing but assumptions, concepts and conventions. So especially principles means concepts. So here, write down. They are universally followed. They are universally followed accounting concepts. They are what? Universally followed accounting concepts. So therefore, concepts means it is universally followed. Concepts means nothing but accounting principles. That's why here we have mentioned. So they are universally followed accounting concepts and procedures. Procedures. Yeah. Next, policies. Policies. Policies hyphen. They are methods to be followed in an adopted accounting principles, in an accounting principle. So what is accounting policy? Accounting policy means they are methods to be followed in an adopted accounting principle. Accounting principle. Yeah. Sir, how it is? How? What's the difference? What's the difference? So just example. Just let me tell you. Let me deviate for a while. So then you can take as a running note here under principles. Whatever we've done. So here you can take running notes. Now, my dear friends, look out. We have to charge depreciation. We have to charge what? Depreciation. So depreciation is a non-cash expense, whatever it might be, for the passage of time or usage. We supposed to charge the depreciation. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So therefore, so here. So here depreciation. So without charging depreciation, now just imagine, I will come back. So depreciation, under depreciation, you can either use SLM method or WDV method, straight line method or written down value method. So these are methods of depreciation.
Yes.
Under this, either you can charge either like 10% per annum, or you can say 10 years is the life. You can depreciate over 10 years. Anything is possible, yes or no? Either based on years or based on percentage also you can depreciate. Correct? Now, my dear friends, without charging depreciation, can you compute profit or loss for the year?
No, sir.
No, correct?
Yes, sir.
So without charging, whether you prepare accounting in India or US or Japan or China or Sri Lanka or Russia or even Antarctica also, correct? Wherever you sit and prepare, so while preparing, before preparing or before finding net profit, you are supposed to charge a depreciation or not?
Yes, yeah? Sir.
So therefore, it is universally followed or not? Therefore, this is called as accounting principle. This cannot be changed. Accounting principle is universally followed. This cannot be changed. This is concept. Are you understanding? Without charging depreciation, we cannot find the profit. This is one concept. If you don't know, you can ask and learn. Nothing wrong. So therefore, it is an accounting concept. So that's what principles are universally followed. Next, my dear friends. Under depreciation, SLM or WDV, we can follow or not? Either SLM, WDV, annuity method, sum of year of digits method, machine hour method, depletion method, etc. Many methods are there. Out of that, just simply here I have mentioned two methods. Correct? So now either SLM or WDV I can choose or not. Yeah?
Yes, sir.
So that means in adopted principle, the methods to follow. This is what methods are not? Methods. Correct?
Yes.
Under that, whatever the supposed sub methods are there, methods are called as accounting policies. Now look out. So what is the definition of accounting policy? They are methods to be followed in an adopted accounting principle. Correct? Suppose if you have adopted, that is, if you want to charge a depreciation, means the charging depreciation is accounting principle. But under depreciation, the methods to be followed, either should I follow SLM or WDV, that company has to decide or not. For their convenient reporting.
Yes,
correct? So that is what their policy, accounting policy. But without charging depreciation, can company prepare the accounts?
No, sir.
That is universal. Therefore, that is accounting principle. But which method you follow, that you have the liberty. So therefore, if you choose, that will work. The methods what you choose to comply, that is what we call it as accounting policy. Correct? Now, under this SLM or WDV, my dear friends, either it's a 10% per annum or 10 years. What is this?
Duration.
How you know?
Depreciation.
Possibly. 10% or 10 years is a depreciation, huh?
So 10% per annum every year, they depreciate 10%.
Yeah, why duration. Is only 10%? Why can't it be 15% or 20%, 30%? Why it is 10 years? Why it is 10 years? Yeah, do you have the answer for that? Yeah, it is nothing but, my dear friend, as an entity, you are believing that this asset is useful for 10 years. Yeah, or if I use this asset, so every year the asset will reduce its value by 10%. That means it is based on your estimate or not.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
therefore, this is called as accounting estimate as per AS 5. All this has been, this segregation has been done in line of accounting standard 5. Are you understanding slowly? So that means here in after, in your accounts, wherever you see expressed in a percentage or expressed in a duration, what it is?
Accounting estimate.
Are you understanding this? This AS5 compliance?
Yeah.
So same thing, my dear friends, like this. So what you know already, so same thing I will show you. Suppose if it is an inventory valuation, have you come across? Closing stock valuation. Yeah. Suppose if closing stock is without valuing the closing, suppose if the stock is there and without valuing the closing stock, can you find a profit or loss? Can you find?
No, sir.
No, therefore, this is accounting policy. Sorry, accounting principle. Under inventory, under valuation of inventory, either you can value at FIFO method or LIFO method or weighted average. Weighted average. So as per AS2, FIFO method should not be followed, but let it be. So either FIFO method, LIFO method, like that, many methods are there. Either of this, any one method you can choose or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this methods, what we call it as accounting policy. Accounting policy. Are you understanding the difference slowly? So then investments are always to be valued at? No, since you are all just a PUC kids, this and all, you might have not known that evaluation of investment, investment accounting, etc. Okay, let it be. So now at this in a depreciation angle, have you understood what is accounting principle means and what is accounting policy means and what is accounting estimate means? Yeah, so depreciation charging, that is principle. Under that, which methods we have to follow, that methods what we call it as accounting policy. Yeah, so under that method, so either it is expressed in a percentage or in a duration, in a time, if it is mentioned, then it is accounting estimate. Then it is accounting estimate. Yeah, come back. Now, my dear friends, let's go with the next definition. So now, accounting principle means it is nothing but what? Concepts. Are you understanding slowly?
Yes, sir.
Principles means it is nothing but concepts itself. So therefore, concepts are nothing but universally followed. Concepts are universally followed. Now, let's go for conventions. Conventions. Yeah, conventions, write down. They are not universally applicable. They depends on entity to entity. They depends or differs. Instead of depends, write it as a differs, my dear friends. Differs. They differs entity to entity. They differs on entity to entity. Yeah. So now, for a time being, don't ask, sir, how it is differs, etc., etc., this and all. As of now, don't ask. So when I, after the completion of my entire chapter, you will understand. Possible. Usually this definitions usually I will write at the end of the chapter, but since here accounting principle and policy, the title is there, so therefore I about to reveal that what is accounting principle and policy. So therefore I have written in a first instance. Now shall we start? Yeah. Now, accounting principles are nothing but it is a concepts. So first let us start with first assumptions. First is what? Accounting assumptions. So part one, accounting assumptions. Assumptions. So out of assumptions, which is the first one?
Going concern.
First one, going concern. Going concern. Now, yes. Now, anyone, can you tell me what do you mean by going concern?
When a business goes on, it doesn't have any end.
Business does not have any end.
End.
Correct. Huh? So, okay. Now, can you tell me which situation will brings that? So, business or which is an example for the business is maintaining going concern assumption. Can you give an example or instance? Can you give an example or instance where business is assuming or business is assuming or business is following going concern?
Sir, taking long-term loans.
Taking long-term loans. Huh? So why long-term loan here? So here, look out first this example. In this example of depreciation, how you have estimated the useful life of an asset is 10 years?
Yes, sir.
Correct. So that means if the business life is enduring, but out of that you are estimating at least up to 10 years, this asset can be used in a business.
Yes, sir.
Correct. So that means, so that is estimating useful life itself, one of the instance that so business is following going concern. Are you understanding slowly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. So now, okay, that's fine. So now, again, so any other angle of interpretation, my dear friends, you are correct. I'm not denying that you are correct. So any other student. So here, interaction is very important, my dear friends. It should not be one way. Yes. So what do you mean by going concern? Yes, Shriyari?
Sir.
Really, sir.
Business is assumed to continue forever.
Assumed to continue forever. Correct? Huh? So, okay, fine. So that means, my dear friends, here, so business, since it has been started, so we have to assume that, so business is going to run forever. Maybe you have been appointed as an accountant, you might be working 1 year or whatever it might be, that's your life. But business, even if you leave the company also, company will continue. That is the assumption. Are you clear with Uday? Yeah. So here, write down. As per going concern, business. Instead of business, write it as entity. Entity life is assumed to be enduring. Enduring, that is infinite. Assumed to be infinite. Are you understanding slowly? Yeah. So now, if going concern assumption is safeguarded, my dear friends, then majority of the concepts will be safeguarded. Yeah. Here, first write down. So business concern, going concern. It is fundamental accounting assumption. Fundamental accounting assumption. What is this? Fundamental accounting assumption. So next, if going concern is safeguarded, then all accounting concepts will hold good means will be fine enough. Continue. If going concern is violates, then majority of accounting concepts will get violates. That is, our example, if going concern is violated, then assets and liabilities should be recognized in balance sheet at realizable values rather than its cost, historical cost, rather than cost. Cost means historical cost. Usually, my dear friends, assets should appear at its book value, na, at cost. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Usually, assets should appear in a book at cost. Even after depreciation also, after depreciation, whatever the remaining WDV is there, that will appear in a book. Yes or no? So
yes.
That's why this year we call it as cost. Subsequent year we call this as historical cost, because this is the last year expense or not?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, suppose if going concern is violated, going concern is violated means, my difference. So for Uday purpose, let me tell you what is going concern means. Look out, today, suppose, imagine if you have been appointed as an accountant today for a business. Correct? Uday, are you there?
Yes, sir.
యా సో ఇప్పుడు నువ్వు అకౌంటెంట్ గా ఒక ఒక కంపెనీలో గానీ ఒక బిజినెస్ ఫామ్ లో గానీ చేరితే, సో ఆపద్దు నీ ఫీల్స్ నీ అజంప్షన్స్ ఏవై ఉండాలంటే, బిజినెస్ ఇప్పుడు నువ్వు నిన్ను అపాయింట్ చేసిన దానికి బిజినెస్ అట్లీస్ట్ నీకైనా ఎన్నో రోజులు కంటిన్యూ అవుతుంది అనే ఫీలింగ్స్ భావన నీ దగ్గర ఉండాలి. కరెక్టా? సో అది కామన్ సెన్స్. నువ్వు చేరినాకలనే పోయి మేనేజ్మెంట్ దగ్గర ఎప్పుడు నువ్వు బిజినెస్ ని క్లోజ్ చేస్తావు అని అడగకూడదు. అడిగితే ఏమవుతుంది? కరెక్ట్. సో అదే కామన్ సెన్స్ అని చెప్పింది. దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ అసంప్షన్స్. కరెక్టా? సో దాన్ని ఎవరు 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 ఎవరి చేత అయినా అడిగి నేర్చుకునే అవుతుందా? ఎవరు ఎవరు ఎవరి చేత ఎవరితో అడిగితే వాళ్ళు నిన్ను కుళ్ళు చేస్తారా లేదా? కరెక్ట్. సో అందుకోసం అడగకూడదు. సో దట్ మీన్స్ మై డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, if you have joined today and if you ask that, so you have to assume that the business will run forever. So that's what your inbound feeling. Suppose if you ask the day of joining itself when the business is going to an end, so then it will be a trouble. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah. So that is what fundamental accounting assumption. That means if before, whether you know accounts, that is secondary. If you have been appointed as an accountant, what is your first feeling? Since the business has been appointed as, this business has to run forever and it will run forever. That is what you are believing. Are you understanding? So therefore, so suppose if this is 10 years is a life, suppose out of that life, out of that complete life enduring, we don't know how far it is. Like the baby which has been born today, so the day one of the baby got its birth, so what all will wish? Live forever, or at least that 100 years is just a criteria. Live it. So it is like 99 years lease, like that, long term. Yeah, like all everyone, parents, this and all, what parents wish? So our baby has to live forever. Yes or no?
Yes,
yeah. So just they have invited you. So since we got a baby, so please come and visit a hospital or whatever it might be. So just meet. Yeah. So as a gratitude, you too went. So the moment baby is the moment you have taken a baby. So if you ask when this baby will going to die, how will be reaction? Huh? It's a common sense or not?
Yes, sir.
Now are you understanding what assumptions, what I have assumed? So now, so therefore, out of 10 years, now look out. Suppose if asset is purchased for 10 lakh, and every year you are estimating that every year 1 lakh will reduce. Correct? 1 lakh will reduce. So that means look out. So at this Y0, when you purchase 10 lakh, after 1 year, how much is the value?
9 lakh.
After second year?
8, 7, 6, 5.
I'm talking about minus 1 lakh means for the usage, if the value of an asset is reduced, this is called as depreciation. This is called as what?
Depreciation.
So therefore, depreciation has been reduced. Therefore, even here, look out, this year when you purchased, this 10 lakh is your cost. Will you agree?
Yes, sir.
Same thing, if I ask next year, what is this value of an asset? 9 lakh, you will say. That is, array, I purchased last year for 10 lakh, you will say. Not that this is 9 lakh only cost. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Today's newspaper, tomorrow's?
Waste paper,
correct? So then, so whatever, that's today, if it is progress, tomorrow it will be history or not?
Yes,
yeah, that's why. So therefore, this year is a historic. That's what, on this 10 only, we are reducing 1 lakh, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes, sir.
Therefore, this cost, what we call it as historical cost. Current year, first year, I call this as a cost. And for second year, third year onwards, I call this is First year I purchased for 10 lakh. That means based on 10 lakh only this reduction has been done. Therefore now this 8 lakh, 9 lakh, whatever is there, these are all called as WCVs, which is nothing but historical cost. Are you understanding slowly?
Yes.
Yeah. So now these are like what we said. So here. So now look out. If it is business is continuing, that is business is life is running forever, then you can continue these assets at these values. Every year 1 lakh reduced. Therefore, you can say, oh, this asset is worth for 9 lakh, 8 lakh, 7 lakh, like that. You can maintain. Yeah. Suddenly management decides that so today after 3 years, that is year 1, year 2, and year 3. Yeah. So now after depreciation, it is 7 lakh. 7 lakh, but business has the management has decided to close the business. Now in the market when you compare, so this asset is worth only for 4.5 lakh. Now tell me, if you carry at cost, is it worth?
No, sir.
No, because you are going to liquidate, you are going to close the business means. So if you sell this asset, at what price you can realize? At that price only it has to be appear or not?
Sure.
Yeah. So therefore now if you are going to close means here going concern, what you thought the life, the business will run forever, now it has been going to die or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
so that means its going concern is affected or not? If going concern is affected, automatically so assets will not appear at its cost, it has to be appear at its realizable values, not at cost. Are you understanding slowly? Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. So now tell me, which is fundamental accounting assumption?
Going concern.
If going concern assumption is violated, then what will happen? Majority of the accounting concepts also will get violated. Are you understanding?
Sure.
Yeah. So now example, classic example is if going concern is affected, so assets and liabilities has to be appear in a balance sheet at its realizable values, not at cost. Yeah. So now going concern, one assumption have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now let's go to second assumption. So what is second assumption?
Consistency.
Consistency. Yeah. Consistency. Yes. Now, my friends. So now let us see, so commerce students, for them, because Uday is a non-commerce, therefore everything is a new for him. Yeah, Uday, every day revise cheyaka class ko koorchunte, it is a big blunder for you. Every day you have to revise. Yeah. Next, consistency. Let us see, my difference. So commerce students, others, so can tell me, what do you mean by consistency?
Sir, a firm should maintain the same type of accounts throughout its lifetime.
Throughout its lifetime,
Until there's any change,
management intends to change.
Unless
management intends to change.
Management. So management anytime they can change, whenever they feel.
Unless change is required.
That is how they know that unless that change is required. How they know? How they come to know that change is required?
Inefficiency or changing government policies.
Government policies. Very good. Very good. Very good. Little bit at least. Key terms you are using.
Comparing the companies.
Wait. Yashaswini, can you speak?
Comparing companies reporting from one period to another.
Mm-hmm. That is what consistency, na? Yeah, Sriyari?
Sir.
Siddharth?
Sir, change in trend.
Change in?
Trend.
Change in trend,
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. ಸೊ ಇರು ನಿನ್ನ ನೋಡೋಣ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡು ಅದೇನ್ ಟ್ರೆಂಡ್ ನೋಡೋಣ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೋ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಾಲಿಸೀಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್ ಎಂಟಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ expected to follow in current years also in preparation and presentation of financial statements. Are you getting the meaning?
Yes, sir.
Right. So consistency means the principles and policies followed in earlier years are expected to follow in current year in current year also in preparation and presentation of financial statements. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So principles and policies, what you have followed, the same thing is expected to follow in current year. The moment that is, sir, how you can say? That means since you have been appointed as an accountant, so what's your responsibility? First feeling is business, you have to assume that business will run forever.
Yes, sir.
Correct, going concern. Second one, you have to assume, so that is what the business, what that is that this business, what principles and policies they were following in earlier years are expected to follow in current year. That means business is expecting from you same principles to be followed or not?
Yes, sir.
So that means the moment you have become an appointant, the accountant, you can't go and say, or you can't go and argue, or you can't go and say, no, I have become an accountant, therefore I will do of my own. So here we are paying the salary to maintain our status quo, not yours. Yes or no? So therefore, what company's policies, principles and policies are there, that you have to follow, for that only salary. Got it? So the moment you have been appointed as an accountant, so don't say last year you have followed depreciation in straight line method. So since I have been appointed, I have not studied straight line method in our PUC or whatever it might be. I know only WDV, therefore I will follow WDV. Is it possible?
No.
No. Correct? If you say so, the moment first day itself, they will throw you out or not? Array, what we are following, follow that first. That's what they expect. So that you can't go and ask with the management or someone. You can't ask with your friend. So by calling, look out, company is following this principle. So can I require to follow the same? If you ask, they will make a fun out of you or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah? Array, stupid, it is your duty. What they were following, you have to follow. Yeah? So like this, your friend will scold you. Correct? So it's a common sense. Therefore,
yes,
so what is consistency means? The principles and policies followed in an earlier year are expected to follow in the current year also in preparation and presentation of financial statements to help, that is AID, aid, to help comparison. Are you understanding, Yashasvini?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, this point you have touched but not clear. That's why I asked. So, can you try or can you be liberal?
Okay.
So, financial statements to help comparison. Now, what are the types of comparisons we have?
Four types of comparisons.
Yeah, we have four. One is intra-firm comparison. Inter-firm comparison,
industry
comparison, and economy comparison. Are you understanding now point? Whatever the words I am using, for that I am already given the meanings. Now, so I said here, my dear friends, here the principles and policies followed by an entity, principles and followed are expected to follow in a current year also in preparation and presentation to help the comparison. Continue. unless change is unless change is initiated by management. Unless change is initiated, or initiated means what?
Started.
Required. Change is required by management. If management said that to change, then only you can change the method. It is not by your own. Correct? So now, so Sri Arya, for whom I asked this, so he said management, and if management want, they can change that point. I have used, correct? For that, I have digged further or not? When management, why management will change, etc.?
Yes, sir.
That question you have to ask. Yes, sir. Sir, you also said the same thing. So now tell me, when management will change? That question you have to ask. Ask.
When management will change, sir?
So therefore, now. Now look out. Unless change is initiated by management. Now, so accounting principles and policies should not be changed unless management required, correct? So therefore, now when principles...